life. Love is on the move when the Father's in the room. Miracles take place, the cynical find faith, and love is breaking through when the Father's in the room. Jericho walls are breaking, strongholds now are shaking. Love is breaking through when the Father's in the room. Love is breaking through.
Good morning. Good morning. Oh, you're almost there. He is risen. Amen. It is a good day, a good time to be here in the presence of the Lord, and we want to worship together. And let me give you just a couple of reminders. A lot of things going on. It's good to see a number of you. Some of you I haven't seen for a year. You still look the same. You didn't age at all. So that's extra $5 in the offering when you go out. But it is good to be able to worship today. And just a reminder of the importance of giving and supporting the church. You have been very faithful through all of this COVID, and I appreciate that. If you haven't been here for a while, our offering boxes are at the back doors, and we don't pass a plate, so you can participate in that. Also, don't forget the closing out the spring flower drive for the teens, and you want to make sure you get those orders in, and RADA and all kinds of stuff going on. But then this evening, there'll be no activities here this evening. I encourage you to spend time with your family or go to church with a family member who would be having services tonight that you may not get the opportunity to do. But we are glad that you are here, and we have just come to worship the Lord, and join with us here in just a moment. We want to pray for Jamie Parsons, who is currently under observation in the hospital. They're waiting on her cardiologist to check her out. They think it may be gallbladder. She went in yesterday evening. So remember to pray for Jamie. And then a friend from Charleston First Church who watches us faithfully online, Connie Parsons, who has had blood clots in her legs, and we want to pray for Connie as well. Would you bow your heads for just a moment today? Lord, I thank you that you have given us this day. What a privilege it is to come into your house and be reminded of your greatness. I thank you, Lord, that you have already met with us. And I pray, Lord, that as we open our hearts, our ears, our minds, that we will hear from you today. And may we lift our hearts and our voices to you in praise in all that we do. Lord, be with these special needs, those who are unable to be with us today due to sickness. Draw close to Janie and to Connie, especially today. Lord, take our worship, and may your name be glorified. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. You can put a smile on your face. It helps. You can even put your hands together.
I know he rescued my soul. His blood has covered my sin, I believe.
believe it.
My Redeemer lives. 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 You lift my burdens. I'll rise with you. I'm dancing on this mountain top to see your kingdom come. My Redeemer lives. 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 My Redeemer lives.
Give the Lord thanks and praise today. Amen. Amen. My Redeemer lives. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
In Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are stilled, when striving cease. He's my comforter, my all in all. Here in the love of Christ I stand. There in the ground his body lay, light of the world by darkness slain. Ooh. Then bursting forth in glorious day, up from the grave he rose again. And as he stands in victory, since curse has lost its grip on me, for I am his and he is mine, bought with the precious blood of Christ.
Think about it.
No guilt in night, and no fear in death. This is the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my destiny. No power of hell, no scheme of man can ever pluck me from his hand till he returns or calls me home. Here in the power of Christ I'll stand. Till he returns or calls me home, here in the power of Christ I'll stand.
Amen. Praise him this morning. Amen. Amen. I want us this morning, as we prepare our hearts, we're going to go into the message. And as we've looked at the message and we begin to understand, give me just a second here.
See what we've got here, Jeff. There you go. As we think of Christ's life, we've looked at his the very fact that he was born, that he lived his life. We looked that he taught in those years. We looked at last week that he died. But praise God, that's not the end of the story. He rose again. He rose again. But there's still very much a significance in understanding his death and his burial and his resurrection and helping us to fully comprehend Easter. Easter. Sharon Neal's mom posted something on Facebook. And you can tell Alana that I told on her. She said, "When did Easter become like Christmas with all the gifts?" I saw her at church this morning and she said, "I saw kids getting bicycles for Easter." So we sort of lose perspective, don't we? We are here to celebrate the risen Savior. We are here to acknowledge that our Lord did not stay in the grave. There's not a tombstone somewhere with his name on it because he has died and he is buried there. He is alive. And I rejoice in celebrating Easter. I love Christmas. I love other religious holidays. But Easter culminates it to the point of us understanding the full purpose. Easter validates all that Jesus said in his teaching, all that he did on earth, and for all eternity, it validates who he is. And without Easter, without celebrating the risen Savior, we would have no hope. Be reminded of that. His death, his blood covers our sins. But without him rising from the dead, we would have no hope. Let's look at scripture this morning that's found in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 3 through 6. "For what I have received, I passed on to you as of first importance, that Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, that he was buried, that he was raised on the third day according to the scriptures, and that he appeared to Cephas and then to the 12. After that, he appeared to more than 500 of the brothers and sisters at the same time, most of whom, as this is being written, are still living, though some have fallen asleep." Some have died. As we look at this scripture, we begin to understand that Paul is saying, everything that I'm telling you is truth. It's a part of scripture. Understand it from the beginning of his life to the very ending and to his ascension into heaven. In verses 19 through 20, it says, "If only for this life we have hope in Christ, we are of all most to be pitied." Do you see what Paul's saying? He's saying, if our hope is only for this life, these few short years that we live in comparison to eternity, if that's all there is, then surely we are a people who should be pitied. But he goes on and says, "But Christ has indeed been raised from the dead, and the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep." Don't just think that this is it. Don't just think that you're living for only this life. There is much more. Hope is the theme of all scripture. Hope for eternity. Hope for today and tomorrow. Understanding that Christ raising from the dead brought hope. 1 Corinthians, remember that scripture. If it's only for the hope that we experience right now, then we're to be pitied. But we have the assurance of knowing that it is more than just today. We have the hope of knowing that we have Jesus, eternity, heaven in our view. So there's hope for this life. Aren't you glad? I mean, it's been a year of this pandemic. Aren't you glad that as believers that we have had hope all the way through to today? Hope. We didn't live as if everything was a total disaster and that we were going to fail and fall apart. We lived with the hope of Jesus Christ in our hearts that whatever comes, He will be with us. He will never leave us. He will not forsake us. And it's not just about heaven. We have hope for the here and now. We have hope while we walk on this earth. There are three things that I want us to quickly see this morning. Three ways that we have hope for today. Understand them clearly. Examine your hearts. Know what it says. We have hope because of the forgiveness of sin. We have hope because our sins can be forgiven. Romans tells us, if you declare with your mouth, Jesus is Lord, and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For it is with your heart that you believe and are justified. It is with your mouth that you profess your faith and are saved. Knowing the importance of being forgiven of our sins. He rose that we might have forgiveness of sin. Belief in Jesus brings us to the point and the understanding that it includes death, the burial, the resurrection that brings forgiveness of every sin we have ever committed. Every sin we have committed. Now, we as humans sometimes like to look at our neighbors and say, oh my, you know him. I mean, he's got this big sin. We look at ourselves and say, well, I just lie a little bit. I just cheat on things just a little bit. But he's got a big sin. Can I tell you? In God's sight, there are no big or little sins. Sin is sin. So he offers us a living hope in forgiveness of our sins. And we must receive that. That's where we find the hope. It says again, if we confess our sins, he's faithful and just to forgive us and will forgive us our sins and purify us from all unrighteousness. He will change us. He will forgive those things. Anything that breaks the heart of God, anything that we say or do that breaks the heart of God, is a sin. Seeking forgiveness of our sins, we acknowledge that what you have done is against God's word. That's what we have to see. It's not just the words of God, forgive me. It's coming to the place of acknowledging that we have sinned, that we have sin in our lives, and we acknowledge that it goes against God's word, and we come to that place and we ask for forgiveness. And the greatest message I can tell us today is found in Psalm 103. As far as the east is from the west, so far has he removed our transgressions from us. Aren't you glad never to be remembered again? And old Satan comes up to us and says, oh, I know how you used to be. Oh, I know what you used to do. Scripture tells us that the sins that have been covered by the blood of Jesus Christ are forgiven and are as far as the east is from the west. Can you tell me when you stop going east and you start going west? Not till you turn around. They never meet. They never meet. You can go north and then you'll start back south. Understanding that when God forgives us, He does it right. Never to be remembered anymore. Don't fall into the trap of our past failures and sins to take us captive in our thoughts and in our minds. I want us to know that forgiveness and restoration from God prompts us to do the same thing for others. That's what He taught. That's what Jesus taught. We talked about it 2 weeks ago, that Jesus taught that we are to forgive as He forgives us. That's not much fun, is it? I mean, you don't know what they did to me. You don't know how I've been mistreated. You don't understand how badly it hurt me. And we say those things, and we come to that place, and we're reminding ourselves of all this hurt, and we begin to ask ourselves, how could I ever forgive them? I won't. Sometimes we just say, I won't. I can't. But then I'm reminded that Jesus could have said the same thing about me. You know, you don't know how much that scourging hurt me. You don't know how much those nails going into my hands and my feet hurt me. You don't know how being talked about, how being accused hurt me. But I still will forgive you. How could we be so selfish in thinking of the forgiveness that He gives to each of us? There's a little story of a lady who had gone to the doctor. She had been bitten by a rabid dog. And it was looked as if that she was going to die from rabies. The doctor told her to put her affairs in order, maybe to make her will and the necessary things. And she immediately said, could I have a pen and paper? The doctor thought, well, this is a little bit strange. So she begins writing. And she continues to write. And he thinks, ma'am, are you writing your last will and testament? Is it necessary right now? And she looked at the doctor and stared at him for a little bit. And she said, writing a will? Absolutely not. I'm making a list of people that I'm going to go bite. So sometimes we get ahead of ourselves thinking that we're going to take revenge into our own hands. We're going to take things into our hands. And yet the Lord teaches us and tells us it's important that we forgive without being asked to forgive them. The second thing that I want us to see is that we have hope because there's victory over sin. There is victory over sin. Romans tells us, when we therefore buried with Him through baptism into death, in order that just as Christ was raised from the dead through the glory of the Father, we too may live a new life. He transforms us. He changes us and gives us victory over the sin that so easily entangled us and grips us. In the same way, count yourself dead to sin, but alive in God, to God in Jesus Christ. Dead to sin, but alive in Christ. You see, it's all in how we put our priorities in order. It's all in how we think and the perspectives that we take on our lives. The Bible says that sin is bondage. When we live in sin, we live as slaves to it. Sin rarely appears as slavery, especially when you're in the midst of it. It seems attractive. And so we don't see the chains that entangle and hold our souls. But there's victory. Just as Christ arose from the grave, there is victory over sin. The resurrection of Jesus broke the chains of sin, and everyone said, Amen. Broke those chains of sin. Also, the hope that we have on this Easter Sunday morning is a full and abundant life that we can live. Don't you want to live a full and abundant life? Don't you want to live a life that is joyful? A life that has peace and contentment and hope? John 10:10. Understand that the thief is Satan. The thief comes only to steal, to kill, to destroy. We can put it this way. Sin comes into your life only to steal, kill, and destroy you. Jesus says, I have come that they may have life and have it to the full. I have come that you may have life and have it abundantly. Have it more than you could think or ask. The Bible is full of hope and promise for the family of God. You can find encouragement. You can find help in your times of need. The Word of God is there for us, and the Holy Spirit will minister to us through the Word. I guess I would ask us, do you look at each day as an opportunity? Full of hope of what God is going to do for you today. Now, I'm not talking about financial blessings. I'm not talking about things that he will do. I'm talking about just his very presence that walks with you. Do you get up in the morning and you just expect another day in the presence of the Lord? Do you go through the day that no matter what comes your way, that you will acknowledge that God is moving, that God is working, even if you don't understand it? Anybody ever been there? God, I don't understand what you're doing, but I'm not going to waver. I'm not going to shrink back. I'm going to continue on. God is moving and working in your life. Romans tells us that all things work together for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose. We may not understand it at the time. We may not understand it even in this lifetime, but I can tell you that everything that comes in and through our lives, God will work good through it, helping us to understand his good and his perfect will. And Jesus rose to give us hope for today by giving us the forgiveness of sins when we receive it. Victory over those sins, that we don't have to be bound to sin and to be able to live a full and abundant life each and every day. Each and every day. Jesus rose to give us hope for tomorrow. Hope for tomorrow. We don't have to fear what tomorrow may bring. We don't have to fear what eternity may be. He brings us hope for tomorrow. If only for this life we have hope in Christ, we are people much pitied. But Christ has indeed been raised from the dead, and the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. It's basically saying to us that because of Jesus, We have hope of eternity. We have hope of being in His presence. Hope for today and tomorrow. Taking your eyes off your circumstances and placing them on God. We're to live in that hope of the resurrection and walk in trusting obedience and anticipating the full and abundant life that Jesus came to give you. Each and every day, live in hope. Possess the hope. You can possess the hope of heaven for yourself. That's the good news. That's the good news. The good news is we all can have all of that. You're not going to get to heaven because your grandmother was a saint of the Lord. You're not going to get to heaven because your parents brought you to church. You're not going to get to heaven because somebody wants you there. The only way to get to heaven is a personal experience with Jesus Christ. It says in Romans 10, if you declare with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For it is with your heart that you believe and are justified, but it is with your mouth that you profess your faith and are saved. It is with your mouth, it is with your life that you live day by day that affirms the fact that you are a child of the King. A daily walk. What does it mean to believe? It means that you're putting all of your hope in one thing. When you're putting all of your hope in the Lord Jesus Christ, when you're putting all of your desires, all of your future into the hands of Jesus, there can be hope. I'm here to tell you that He rose to give us hope for today and for eternity. Kim is going to come. I want us to bow our heads. The question that I would ask us this morning is, where is your hope? Is your hope found in the home that you have, your bank accounts, the cars that you drive, the friends or the family? Is that where you're securing your hope? Or is your hope found in Jesus Christ? The one who can forgive us of all of our sins and wrongdoings. I want my hope to be found in Jesus. Lord, I pray that you would speak to our hearts. I pray, Lord, that we may affirm those who are believers, that we may affirm our hope is found in you. And Father, I pray that if there are those who have placed their hopes in things of this earth or people or money, that they would see a need for a Savior who not only died and was buried, but He kept His promise and He rose from the grave and sits. You sit at the right hand of God. Speak to our hearts. Move in us today. And in the name of Jesus, we pray these things. Amen. Thank you.
from above. I've been out to the river, and I ain't the same. A prodigal returned. To no prison, I've worn shackles and chains. Well, I've been freed and forgiven. I'm not going back. I'll never be the same. Well, thank God my yesterday's gone, and all my sins are forgiven. Well, I've been washed by the blood. There's a kind of thing that just breaks a man, breaks him down to his knees. God, I've been broken more than a time or two. Then he picked me up and showed me what it means to be a man. Well, thank God my yesterday's gone. Well, and all my sins are forgiven. Oh, and I've been washed by the blood. He came to love, heal and forgive. He lived and died to buy my pardon. An empty grave is there to my Savior lives.
How sweet to hold a newborn baby and feel the pride and joy He brings, but greater still, the calm assurance that child can face a certain case because He lives.
My Savior, my joy,
Aren't you thankful for that assurance today that he lives, and because of that, we can face tomorrow. I just want to praise him today. You know, this is the most holy day of the Christian calendar, and I just want to give him glory today. And before we even chose these songs, I had no idea what Randy's message was going to be. But as I was sitting there listening to him, this last song that we're going to do for you just goes right along with that. Aren't you thankful that he is our living hope today?
Amen.
The chasm that lay between us, how high the mountain I could not climb. In desperation, I turned to heaven and spoke your name into the night.
Then through the darkness, your saw through the shadows of my soul. The work is finished, the end is written. Jesus Christ, my living hope. Who could imagine so great a mercy? What heart could fathom such boundless grace? The God of ages stepped down from glory to wear my sin and bear my shame. The cross has spoken, I am forgiven. The King of Kings calls me his own. Beautiful Savior, I'm yours forever. Jesus Christ, my living hope. Hallelujah, praise the one who set me free. Hallelujah, death has lost its grip on me. You have broken every chain. There's salvation in your name, Jesus Christ, my living hope. Hallelujah, praise the one who set me free. Hallelujah, death has lost its grip on me. You have broken every chain. There's salvation in your name, Jesus Christ, my living hope. Then came the morning that sealed the promise. Your very body began to breathe. Out of the silence, the roaring lion declared the grave has no claim on me. Then came the morning that sealed the promise. Your very body began to breathe. Out of the silence, the roaring lion declare the grave has no claim on me. Jesus, yours is the victory. Hallelujah, praise the one who set me free. Hallelujah, death has lost its grip on me. You have broken every chain. There's salvation in your name.
Jesus Christ, my living hope. Hallelujah, praise the one who set me free. Hallelujah, death has lost its grip on me. You have broken every chain. There's salvation in your name, Jesus Christ, my living hope. Jesus Christ, my living hope. God, you are my living hope.
Amen. Amen. Aren't you thankful for that living hope? And isn't it good to see a choir back up here? Praise the Lord. They've been practicing. So Wednesday evenings, you can still come out. God help us. Amen. We're going to stand and we're going to close out this service singing your lungs out. Can you do that? All right. Lift your voices and praise Him. He is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Put a smile on your face. Are you excited about your Savior?
Let the children sing the song of liberation. The God of our salvation set us free. Death, where is thy sting? The curse of sin is broken. The empty tomb stands open. Come and see. He's alive, 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 hallelujah. Alive, praise and glory to the Lamb. He's alive, 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 hallelujah. Alive forever, amen.
Let my heart sing out. Christ the one and only, so powerful and holy, rescued me. Death won't hurt me now, because He has redeemed me. No grave will ever keep me from my King. I'm alive, 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 hallelujah. Alive, praise and glory to the Lamb. I'm alive, alive, alive.
The one who has overcome the grave. Let the people dance, let the people sing. Worthy is the mighty King. Worthy is the Lamb, worthy of the praise. Worthy is the one who has overcome the grave. Let the people dance, let the people sing. Worthy is the mighty King. Worthy is the Lamb, worthy of the praise. Worthy is the one who has overcome the grave. Let the people dance, let the people sing. Worthy is the mighty King. Worthy is the Lamb, worthy of the praise. Worthy is the one who has overcome the grave. Let the people dance, let the people sing. Worthy is the mighty. He's alive, 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 hallelujah. Alive, praise and glory to the Lamb. Yes, He's alive, 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 hallelujah. Alive forever, amen. He's alive.
This morning. He is alive. Amen. He is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Just a reminder, let's socially gather outside, okay? This crowd will go out these doors, and this crowd will go out the center doors. Wave at somebody. Say, He is risen. He is risen indeed. May God bless you on this day. Amen.
I searched the world, but it couldn't fill me. Man's empty praise and treasures of fame. And there